Did you accept the invitation to the great banquet? A wedding ceremony is one of the most important events in a person's life. Most of the people start their wedding preparations years or months ahead. If we look at the checklist before the wedding, there are 100 of things to do. First of all, they pick a preferred date for the wedding. Secondly, they fix a venue for the wedding reception. Then they plan out the budget. Next, they figure out the guest list. Here, they have to select the very important persons, relatives and friends whom they expect to be at the wedding ceremony. Moreover, they have to carefully select the food items and their portions. Apart from these, the couple must select their wedding dresses and jewelries. They also book photographers, musical bands, makeup artists, and decor crew. Finally, they print their wedding invitation cards. After all these preparations, if someone invites you to their son's or daughter's wedding, it means you are really an important person for them. But when you receive this invitation, if you refuse this invitation in their face, that means you don't want to have any relationship with them anymore. In today's gospel, we find a similar situation. Today, we have the parable of the great wedding banquet. In this parable, there is a king who is throwing a great feast for his son's wedding. He sends out his servants to invite the guests. They were supposed to come to the party, but they refused the invitation. In this parable, the king is God the Father and his son is Jesus Christ. This great feast itself is the heavenly banquet. The servants of the king went to the invited guests, and each one of them had an excuse to refuse this invitation. They gave prominence to their jobs, to their farms. They were worried about making money and managing their property. They had attachments to this world, and they were not ready to accept this great invitation. These guests who did not respond to king's invitation are the so-called chosen people or the Jews. They insulted and killed God's messengers or God's prophets. Next, the king in the parable sent his servants to invite everyone who were not worthy, those who had nothing. They are the sinners, the outcasts, and the Gentiles. It means when the good news was preached to the Gentiles and sinners, they accepted it very willingly. Therefore, God the Father has extended the invitation of salvation to both good and bad alike. In the latter part of the parable, we come across a person who is not wearing a wedding garment. The guests without a wedding garment are those who try to enter the kingdom of God without a proper preparation and without a proper disposition. Our Lord said, "Repent, turn away from your sins and accept the gospel." So, those who don't want to repent and change their sinful lives are those who have failed to wear a wedding garment. God's invitation to share heavenly joy depicts God the Father's outpouring love for us. In the first reading, Prophet Isaiah describes the rich banquet that the Lord prepares for his children. There will be an abundance of food and drinks. At the heavenly feast, nobody will be left wanting. The Lord will take death, tears of suffering, and humiliation away from his people, and all will be truly satisfied with the bliss of salvation that they receive. Today, we have the Lord's Eucharistic banquet at the Holy Mass. Through the Holy Mass, Lord Jesus is giving us an invitation to be in communion with him. Every Eucharistic celebration is a foretaste of heavenly banquet in God's kingdom. Every Sunday, Jesus Christ gives all of us this invitation to take part in his great banquet. But many of the faithful turn down this great invitation. Like those invited guests in the parable, some of us give our own excuses for not attending the Sunday Mass. At times, we give prominence to our jobs, to our businesses, to our household chores, our relaxation, and to entertainment. We think of satisfying these human needs are far more important than the Holy Communion. We are not ready to give one single hour of the week to be in communion with Lord Jesus Christ. On the other hand, there are others who attend the Sunday Mass without meaning. They receive the Holy Communion without proper disposition and without proper preparation. Such people are those who come without a wedding garment. We are asked to repent for our venial sins before the Mass, and if there are mortal sins, we should make a confession before the Holy Mass. But some of us just come in and receive the Lord. Sometimes we are late for Mass and without any meaning, without listening to the readings, without any understanding, we receive the Holy Communion. Although we think that we are in communion with the Lord, we have deceived ourselves. One should be in the state of grace, that is, without mortal sin, to be in communion with the Lord. Therefore, let us leave aside all the other preoccupations when we come for Sunday Mass. Let us truly repent and change our hearts. Then we will truly foretaste that great heavenly banquet while we are living on this earth.